Hey everyone, welcome to a brand new end snare percussion lesson. Today we're going to be breaking down one of my favorite hybrid rudiments, flam drags. So before we get started, let's talk about what a flam drag actually is. You can see a picture of them right here in this space. Pretty much, you have your flam with an accent, your diddle, then a tap. Flam accent, diddle, tap. And it's just alternating sticking. So when you're breaking down rudiments, it's important to understand each aspect that goes into the rudiment. First, you have two hands, right? Each of those hands are playing certain things that make up a flam drag, right? So what we're going to be showing you today is one of the secrets to really improve your rudiments, and in this case, flam drags. So all you got to do is take one hand and play it softly, you don't hurt yourself, on your leg. So you're going to proceed to play flam drags like this. Switch. And you don't have to use your leg, you can use the rim or just anything else that's not the pad. And so what you're doing when you break down a rudiment like this is you're finding out, you're discovering what each individual hand is doing on their own. So now that you know what each individual hand is doing, where do you go from there? The first thing you want to do is take away any extra stuff. In this case, the diddles, right? So let's start here. Flam drag. Left hand on the leg. And take out the diddle. Right now we have a brand new rhythm that we're looking at. So the secret to building up rudiments, and in this case flam drags, is to understand that bass rhythm that's happening in your right hand and that's happening in your left hand. So from there, you work on this. Right? And to find out the left hand rhythm, again, we start with the flam drag. Right hand on the leg. Take away the diddle. Cool. Just like that, we have our rhythm in our left hand that we need to work on. So once you understand these basic rhythms that are happening in each hand, then you can start to work on the actual flam drag itself. Would you really believe that that's what you need to work on to improve flam drags? Crazy as it sounds, that's the secret. Obviously, we still don't have the diddle in there, which is a huge part of the flam drag. So what you want to do is really work up each of those hands, right? Just play the flam drag without the diddle. Right, one hand on the drum. Cool, and just chop that out. Same with the other hand. Cool, once you have those basic rhythms established and really firm in your hands, then you can start to focus on the next aspect of the flam drag, which is the actual drag itself, right? So let's do the right hand on the drum, left hand on our leg. Hear that? Cool, so now we have the step two of our new rhythm. We're adding the diddle on. And if you watched our previous lesson where we talked about how to play diddles like the pros, you'll understand that instead of thinking of this as a diddle, you're thinking of it as an actual rhythm. Same with the left hand. So now that you have isolated each individual hand and you've added on the diddles, before you start to put them back together, it's really important that you master each hand separately. Obviously, you have two hands playing when you play a real flam drag, but in order to have the best sound, the best rhythmically correct flam drag, you want to have each of your hands playing perfectly in time. So really spend some quality time with each hand. Like, just put your left hand, like I said, on your leg. You can put it on a pillow, that's what some people like. Some people like the rim if you don't want to hurt your leg. And just spend some quality time just playing slow flam drags with and without the diddle with one hand on the drum. So that's the secret to really building up your rudiments, whether it's flam drags, whether it's cheeses, whether it's book reports, whether it's paradiddles, whatever you want to try and work on. Take your hands, pull them apart, one on the drum, one on your leg, and you'll really start to see an improvement in your rudiments. Okay, the last thing we're gonna do in our lesson today is we have a playthrough of our own flam drag builder. And it's pretty simple. We start playing flam drags at 80 beats a minute, and every 8 measures, we increase the tempo. There's a run through of me playing it at the end that you can use for your own reference. And if you can't play the top tempo of flam drags, that's okay. Don't worry about it yet. Play as far as you can until your hands just, until you're like, whoa, I can't do this anymore. Stop, rest, let the track continue on, and then when you're ready to hop back in, get back in there, right? Because it goes slow from 80 beats a minute all the way up to 160 beats a minute, and then it goes right back down. So if you can play 80 beats a minute, and then the second tempo with the third tempo, but the fourth tempo and the fifth and sixth, you're like, whoa, I can't do this. Then go ahead, stop, rest, let the track keep going on, and then get back in once it drops back down to where you were at initially. So during my run through, I play the entire exercise, the entire flam drag builder on the drum. But feel free to take your left hand, put it on your leg, take your right hand, put it on the rim. It might be easier to put it on the rim if you have a pad with a rim on it, just because it starts to, the flam drags get pretty fast towards the middle of the exercise. But definitely play the entire exercise, both hands on the drum, one hand on the drum, like the right hand on the drum, and then the left hand on the drum. And really like experiment with those different variables so that way you have a perfect understanding of flam drags as you go forward with this rudiment. All right, thanks for tuning in to this lesson, guys. I know it was a short one, but we're gonna do more of these hybrid rudiment breakdowns in the future. If you haven't, make sure to check out some of our previous lessons. We have a video talking about diddles, we talk about traditional grip, and then we also have one of my favorites, an exercise that built insane chops. Make sure to subscribe to us on YouTube, follow us on all our social media accounts, and stay tuned for some awesome things coming up. We have a brand new community event that we're gonna release here pretty soon, and we are just so excited for it. So stay tuned, guys.